Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. You're joining me in the flight deck of the Fenix A320, and we're currently at Châteauroux Airport in central France. In this video, I'm going to talk you through how to set up the Airbus A320 series to conduct visual circuits, or traffic patterns as they're otherwise known. So you may ask, why on earth are we in Châteauroux? Quite simply, it's an airfield I have done a lot of circuits at in the real world, and it's one that's used heavily by a number of major European operators. So that's where we are, central France. So the airport code is Lima Foxtrot Lima X-ray. And here's the airfield itself. Nothing particularly special, certainly in the simulator in terms of scenery. It's very basic. However, it does have a very nice long runway, which is 3.5 kilometres long, 3,500 metres. We prefer to come here when runway 21's in use. That's the favourable runway for conducting traffic patterns here. It is equipped with an ILS on this side as well. The runway does have a slight upslope as you come in on the runway 21 direction. And generally here we try to conduct our circuits from runway 21 on the left-hand circuit. It's a good airport to use as it's not particularly busy. Again, it has that nice long runway. And the weather is pretty decent out here too, although it can bubble up in the summer months and we'll get some thunderstorms. And in the winter months, there can be a fair bit of fog around. So in between, great flying though. So I've currently got the aircraft operating on the APU. We've done all the basic setup from cold and dark and conducted the flows. I've got other videos on that getting us to this point where we're kind of ready to program the MCDU, which is the key bit here for our traffic patterns. So obviously we've still got an element of flight planning to do, in particular in relation to weather. So we want to pull in our latest weather information. We're here now, so we want the current weather, the METAR. So I'm not using live weather for this particular scenario and setup, and obviously here it's showing fog, freezing fog in fact, so it wouldn't be a great day in the real world today conducting circuits at this airfield. But I wanted to remind you of the importance of cross-checking that weather, and also we'd want to pull in the TAF as well, so we can see the forecast through the day. You know, there's anything in the next hour or so which is likely to affect our circuit, so are there thunderstorms moving in, and that kind of thing. Next we go to our init page, and we put in our airport code, Lima Foxtrot Lima X-ray, and again for the arrival, Lima Foxtrot Lima X-ray. We need a flight number. Easy 93 Charlie today. Cost index is not particularly relevant, so we'll put a zero in there. Now for our cruising flight level, I'm going to put our traffic pattern altitude, which is generally 1500 feet above airfield level. So we come over to our charts, we have the airfield here. So the airport's at an elevation of 529 feet. So if we discard the 29 feet, we'll call it 2000 feet, so 1500 and 500. That will give us 1500 feet above the airfield. Put the ground temperature in. So generally we wouldn't enter an alternate, however we need to be mindful that there's a possibility here of the runway getting blocked while we're doing circuits. Someone else may have an issue, maybe there's a few aircraft in the circuit, one of them gets stuck on the runway for whatever reason. We need to have some options available, so do consider a contingency. It is very important to keep an eye on your fuel while you are undertaking your traffic patterns. Next we want to come over to the flight plan page, and we'll select top left there our departure runway. We select runway 21. We don't enter a SID, so we simply insert runway 21, and then we come down to the destination over to the right, and we go down, so we don't select the ILS, we go down and select the 21 visual with no star and insert that. And you obviously starting to populate some lines on our navigation display. So next we want to start thinking about fuel and what our zero fuel weight is and the general loading of the aircraft. So if we come into our mass and balance, so we've got a very light aircraft at the moment, only 44 tonnes with zero fuel weight. Now we have the option, obviously, in the simulator to set this up to be more realistic as per your real world flights. So generally you'll be operating the Airbus probably in the region of 60 to 65 tonnes, if not a little bit more. We're nowhere near that today at the moment. So it depends if you want to practice your circuits for helping your day-to-day flying. So you have the option here, obviously, in the simulator to select a full passenger load, for example, with some cargo. Typically when we're doing circuits, we may have maybe 15 people on board. So we'd have a number of pilots conducting circuits. So it may be that we've got, you know, a whole bunch of trainee pilots coming through to their first touch and goes in the A320. There'll usually be a few instructors and usually someone with a camera, all that kind of thing. Generally speaking, on the fuel side, we'd have, depending how many circuits we've got to get through and how many people are, you know, on board to get through, in the region of 6 to 7 tons maybe, if not a bit more, depending on also looking at things like where will we go in the event of the runway closing. We want to do some basic checks around that. So this is going to be a typical sort of load. It's not very much at all. So I'm going to apply and load that. Now, I'll do that instantly. That's a very light zero fuel weight. Typically, you'll have zero fuel weights when operating around 56 tons in that kind of region, 55, 56, 57, depending on your load density. Operating the Airbus with this weight setup, you will notice, you know, a very big difference. It will climb very quickly, and that's something you need to keep an eye out for in your circuits, as it's quite easy to get caught out maintaining altitudes as we lift off on the runway. Generally we do 6 circuits per pilot. That's about 45 minutes of flying. But it's just myself today, 6 tons should be okay for that. So we can send this over to the MCDU. Then we want to run our performance. Lima Fox, Lima X-ray. Runway 2-1. It's dry today. Ideally we want to go Cockpit 1 plus F, which won't be a problem on this runway. Fill in our figures. So this has got current weather outside. I'm on sort of default. I'm going to go 1013. So we do generally depart from intersection Bravo at this airfield. So if I just come back on to Navigraph, we depart here. Now this chart doesn't give us the exact runway length from Bravo, but we can use the scale here, and typically we use the 1000 meters. It's pretty much bang on, it's 1000 meters, and that's what we'd use in the real world for this particular intersection departure. So we come back into the performance page. We'll go intersection Bravo. Oh, there we go. Takeoff run available. So it's 3,500 minus 1,000, 2,500 meters. Save. Recalculate. 119, 119, 122. Takeoff shift is correct. Flaps 166 on the flex. And that shouldn't be an issue at all at this weight. So we can send that over to the MCDU. Now we can use the alternate time function here. Obviously if we know it's going to take a particular time to get to an airport, or you want to add a bit of extra reserve in, so you may want to allocate some fuel to your alternate. Typically from here we would look to bring the aircraft into Paris, and that's for operational reasons. There are plenty of other options around, so just consider what you want to block out in terms of alternate fuel. It's very important while you're doing the patterns to keep an eye on your extra time there. So we go in, we just verify that data, that we've done between pilots. So we've got the clean speed of 187, 188 here. So this is always to conduct this check, which that's green dot speed, so really they should be spot on. The difference of one knot there is done by rounding up of figures. So that's nothing really to be concerned about. If we get larger variances, we need to start homing in as to why, because that shows there's a difference between the EFB calculations and what the aircraft computers have calculated. So we need to find that discrepancy, what's caused that. So next we want to come over to the approach page. We want to put in as much detail as possible, so pretty much get it set up for the approach. You won't have a lot of time in the air to do this. We're not flying an instrument approach today, so we're flying under visual flight rules, so we don't need to put the minimums in. This page is important because it calculates our approach speed, which is pretty key. You'll find traffic patterns very fast moving, lots to do. Having this set up before you go is ideal. So once we get airborne, we activate the approach phase, we can bring in managed speed. We don't need to worry about messing around in the MCDU, especially as generally in Microsoft Flight Simulator, we're going to be single crewed. There are a couple of things we can now input into our MCDU to help us with our traffic patterns. So when we're flying the circuits, we want to make sure we are the correct distance from the runway when coming downwind. And one thing we can do to help us with that is insert a radius marker around the airfield. And also, we need to start a timer when coming abeam at the runway 21 threshold. So we can also insert a line coming off the 21 threshold as well. And to do that, we come onto the flight plan page. We can left select any fix here, go into fix info on the top right. So to put that line in first, that's a runway threshold reference, Lima Foxtrot, Lima X-ray, and runway 21. Put that into the reference fix. So we need to work out what radial we need to use. So up here we have the runway direction 212, and we want to come off at 90 degrees from that. So 212 minus 90 gives us 122. So we put that radial in there, and you will see the line now drawn on the navigation display for reference. And we can also come over using the right select key here and insert another reference fix here. This time I'm just going to use the airport, Lima Fox, Lima X-ray, put that in, and I'm going to use a 4 mile radius around the airfield. So that's more or less where we want to be, making sure we're not drifting off too far out from the airfield. So it helps us keep an eye on our distance from the airfield. And then we've got the other line here, which helps us identify when we need to start timing, because that's important for judging when to begin our turn for base and final. So those are some really good things to put into the MCDU, and again, best to do those while you're on the ground, because it's a lot of fiddling to do when you're manually flying the aircraft. Then we want to set up our EFIS and FCU. So typically we have constraints, we'll have low range, so tens, pretty normal. We can put some references on here, but that's pilot's discretion. Sometimes you can over clutter your displays, so think about what you want to put on here. You don't have to have VORs on. We come over here and we want to select our circuit height as well today, 2000 feet. So that's the basic setup for flying traffic patterns. Feel free to use the comment section if you have any questions in relation to that. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.